Good morning. Hope you are all safe at home. On behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, Ramsden's Institute of Technology, Coimbatore, I welcome you all for this online course. Today, in this video presentation, we are going to see first about civil engineering. Second, various building materials used in civil construction. Third part, surveying and mensuration. Fourth, application of basic science in engineering. Now, we will enter into the first part of the session about civil engineering. I am L. Agnes T.P., Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Ramsden's Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. What do you think will be the view of a common man about civil engineering? A common man would think a civil engineer is a person who always works under the hot sun fully exhausted. But that is not the only work of a civil engineer. He has various roles in this society and in a nation's development. Now, let us see what are all the roles a civil engineer plays in his life cycle. A civil engineer plans. Planning a structure isn't an easy job, but it is an interesting part of civil engineering. He draws a plan of what has to be done. Design. Creative works give excellent results. A civil engineer designs how his output should be. Develop. A civil engineer could also develop anything new or existing. It could be an innovative product, a design, or a plan. Construct. Practical execution of whatever work he has done, planned, and designed is done. Interpret. Civil engineer could also interpret the future effects with respect to the structure. Maintain. Maintaining the work done by him is also a part of civil engineering. Execute. The final execution of his plan, design, and construction takes out his hard work. So now, what is civil engineering? Civil engineering is a professional discipline of engineering dealing with designing, constructing, and maintaining the natural and physically built environment. Civil engineers are responsible for the buildings of roads, skyscrapers, dams, airports, bridges, tunnels, and such other big structures. Civil engineering not only creates the environment we live in, but improves and protects our lives. Civil engineers are responsible for sustainable energy in this era of fast depleting fuel and resources, and even the supply of clean water. A world without them could be unimaginable. Civil engineering is considered to be the oldest engineering discipline. It is also stated to be the mother of all engineering disciplines. Can you even imagine a life without a building? Civil engineering, it all started when man found his shelters in caves. The development for old ages to the middle age buildings and to the highly remarkable modern era structures. It is all making the impossible to be possible. Now, to understand the work of a civil engineer, we shall watch the video. above seen work are done in various specializations of civil engineering, like structural engineering, to design the bones and muscles that create the form and shape of man-made structures. Geotechnical engineering deals with the soil and rock behavior, the physical, chemical, and mechanical properties of the earth materials. Environmental engineering, protecting the people from the adverse environmental effects like pollution and improving the quality of environment. Irrigation engineering deals with analysis and design of dams, weirs, canals, etc. Construction planning and management. It helps in managing and executing the project successfully. Transportation engineering. Planning, designing, operation and management of any mode of transportation, providing safe, comfortable, convenient movement for the people. Remote sensing and view. It is a measurement of the earth using sensors on airplanes and satellites. Coastal engineering. To construct at or near the coastal areas. Now, let us see how your study on basic sciences is related to civil engineering. We all would have studied some basic science subjects like physics, chemistry, math, biology, or computer science. We shall see how these subjects are related to a engineering field. Math in civil engineering. Math should be loved by an engineer. A civil engineer deals with math every day in his job. The basics of math is necessary to solve the problems in any sector of civil engineering. Physics. Physics in civil engineering. Understanding the forces, energy, motion plays a vital role in civil engineering. The forces acting on the elements of a building decide the design and stability of the building. For example, when a bridge is being designed, physics is used to figure out how large the supporting piers should be, as well as how thick the steel columns of bridge need to be, and how many of them should be installed. Chemistry. The equations of chemistry decide the strength of some material. The titrations and testing help in water quality analysis. Information and communication technology. Information and communication technology has become the advanced and vital part of civil engineering. The softwares and applications have made the work easier for a civil engineer. Biology in civil engineering. Even biology is required for a civil engineer to learn about the work of microorganisms in soil, water, and climate. Hence, dear students, I hope you have gained knowledge about what is civil engineering and how your study of basic sciences helps in studying in civil engineering. In the forthcoming video, you will see a brief about the building materials used in construction, surveying and mensuration, and some basic applications related to basic sciences. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.
A warm greetings to everyone. In this module, we are going to discuss about the various building materials used in construction. Selecting the right construction material is one of the important tasks for the civil engineer. Hence, an engineer must know about the classification, economics, and performance of a construction material. By being aware of this, an engineer can use the construction material in a sustainable manner. The building materials are used to construct the various forms of civil structures such as buildings, dams, bridges, flyovers, towers, skyscrapers, etc. The building materials are broadly classified into two main categories, natural building material and artificial building material. Let us learn something about the natural building materials. The building materials that are naturally available are called natural building material. Some of the natural building materials are mud, stone, sand, wood, leaves, lime, fibers, etc. Mud. People used mud, cow dung, chopped straw to build the walls of the houses. Still, this method of construction is used in mud cladding and flooring. And moreover, mud and cement combine to provide the excellent durability to the finishing surface. Another important construction material is stone. It is used in the ancient times. It is widely used for the construction of building components such as walls, floors, foundation, roof, etc. Some of the stone commonly used today are granite, marble, sandstone, limestone, etc. Next one is the sand. With the effect of rock disintegration, small grains of silica are produced subsequently to form sand. Sources of sand for construction is from river. Sand is used to create many building materials such as concrete, mortars, plasters, etc. Wood. Wood is naturally abundant material. It's an important building material in all the period. The main sources of wood are classified into two types, softwood and hardwood. People mainly use wood for construction of windows, doors, ceilings, roofing, etc. Leaves. With the help of leaves, people used to construct the roof of the structures. Lime. Due to its various benefits, lime is known as ancient cement. Lime has been used as the various constructions such as palaces, bridges, monuments, temples, etc. They are used as the best damp-proofing material in floor, roof, wall, etc. Fibers. Since ancient days, various types of fibers have been used in construction. Some of the major sources are coconut husk, jute fibers, banana leaves, etc. Some of the fibers used in building construction are coir, hay, jute, bamboo. They are also used to improve the soil property if it's mixed with soil. Man-made material. Any material which undergoes human processing is known as artificial building material or man-made material. Cement. It is widely used in construction industries for its high strength and durability. Cement is obtained by burning the well-proportionated mixture of siliceous, argillaceous, calcareous materials and crushing the same into gray color fine powder. It has the ability to bind the loose particles such as gravel and broken stone. It's one of the major features of cement is quick setting property, which in turn used as the famous building material. These were the composition of cement: silica, lime, alumina, iron oxide, magnesia, and gypsum. Gypsum is the major ingredient in a cement, which contribute the setting time. So for about 3 to 5% of gypsum is added at the end of the cement manufacturing process. Next one is the brick. It's a rectangular blocks made from clay. The main composition of bricks are alumina, silica, iron oxide, lime and magnesia. The clay which is to be chosen that should be free from pebbles, gravels, alkalis, organic matters, vegetation and iron pyrites. Applications. Bricks are used in the lintels, columns, walls, etc. A good brick should be red copper in color, have the uniform texture, sharp edges, free from organic matters, sounds a metallic ringing sound, good insulation property against sound and heat. Mortar is a mixture of binding materials like cement or lime with a fine aggregate and water. Mortar is used as a binding material in various types of construction. Paints. It is done to protect the surface from the effect of weathering, to prevent the wood from decay and the metal from corrosion, to provide a decoration finish and to obtain the clean, hygienic and healthy living atmosphere. Metals. One of the important backbone of all construction product is metal and its subproducts. It is used as a construction material in two forms, ferrous metal and non-ferrous metal. Iron and steel comes under the ferrous metal, whereas aluminium, copper and zinc comes under the non-ferrous metals. Most generic example in steel rod, which is usually used in the reinforced cement concrete structures. Aluminium mixes with glasses and used in facade type of construction, which we commonly seen in all skyscrapers. Next is the glass. It is manufactured by heating soda, lime and sand. It is widely used as the construction materials like glazing doors and windows. Plastics. We can say plastic is a versatile material in today's construction. Plastics are available in various forms such as switchboard, tap, domestic furnitures, etc. Modern building materials. Litrocon. Litrocon is a concrete-based building materials having light transmission property. Light transmission property is mainly due to the uniform distribution of plastic or glass optical fibers throughout the body. Hence, it is also known as translucent concrete or litrocons. The materials used in the litrocons are binder, which is cement, fine aggregate, which is sand, coarse aggregate. Instead of coarse aggregate, we are using the transparent alternative materials known as glass fiber or optical plastic fibers. So the fine concrete is the binder and the fine aggregate, and the coarse aggregate is the optical fibers of thickness 2 microns to 2 mm. These fibers blend into concrete like any other aggregate. Flexible transparent fibers made up of glass or plastic transmit light between two ends of the fibers by the process of total internal reflection. These optical fibers have the capacity to transmit the light from source into space enclosed by panels. Since it transmits light, this type of construction is considered as the energy saving method of construction. It provides very good aesthetic appearance for the building. However, casting a litrocon requires skilled labors and cost of construction is pretty high. Next material is the sensile. Concrete of tiles is embedded with the acrylic fiber optic channel that transfer the light from one point to the other. As shadows move across the terrazzo surface, the light channels flickers with a randomized twinkling effect. Sensile is of three forms: random, grid, staggered. As you walk across the kitchen floor to get something from the refrigerator, the floor twinkles with lightened path that guides your way through the dark room. Their tiles are available for use as floorings, bathrooms, ceilings, etc. Next one is the grasscrete. Grasscrete is used for the ground stabilization. It is a cast on-site cellular reinforced concrete system with the voids created by the plastic formers. First method is to prepare a base. Subbase is made up of gravels or stones, and the base is made up of sand of about 10 to 20 mm thickness. These are the plastic formers which to be laid over the compactor sand, and it's of size 600 mm by 600 mm. The third process is we have to place the mesh reinforcement over this formers like this. Next, concrete should be poured over the formers and reinforcement. Ensure concrete is placed around the formers and mesh and level to top of the formers. Allow the concrete for 48 hours to harden and settle. Use the LPG flame gun to melt the former top. It will create a cavity like this. Then the topsoil and seed is mixed and poured over the cavity of formos. The planting must be watered daily over 2 weeks to establish the grass cover. Grass growing still in progress in this picture, and thus the grasscrete is formed. The various application of grasscretes are: it's used in highway lay, railway tracks, road divider, embankments, roof of structures, etc. Next is the paper insulation. It's a superior alternative to all the chemical forms. It is made from the recycled newspapers and cardboards. It resists both insects and fire due to the inclusion of borax, boric acid and calcium carbonate. It can be blown into cavity walls, filling every crack. No health problems to the occupants is detected. Transparent aluminium. Extremely durable crystalline material with having excellent optical transparency. It has excellent clarity and it has high strength and hardness. It's available in various sizes and shapes and also thickness. It's cost effective material. Applicable to avoid the varieties of industries including aerospace, security, defense, semiconductor energy and consumable products. Here, the building is updated from glass to transparent aluminium. Next is the low emissive glass. It's a type of window glass that has been treated with an invisible metal or metallic oxide coating, creating a surface that reflects the heat and the other materials while allows the light to pass through it. It's a typical window. In this, during summer, the heat and the ultraviolet radiations reflected back from the outer window, only the visible light passes through it. During winter, the interior heat reflected back inside to keep the room in a warmer condition. The windows treated with low E coating are proven to reduce the energy consumption, reducing or decreasing the fading of fabric such as window treatments and increasing overall comfort in your home. Kinetic football. What do you mean by kinetic? Kinetic is a movement. The energy of a moving object is known as kinetic energy. In civil construction field, we are introducing an energy conserving technology as a replacement of tiles. The floor tiles generate electricity through the deformation of materials under a load. The technology converts kinetic energy to electrical energy. It can be stored and used for various applications. Tiles can be used indoors or outdoors in high traffic areas and generate electricity from pedestrian footfall. If we implement this technology, we can supply the power to grids such as pedestrian lightings. Tiles are completely renewable and eco-friendly. We can reduce about 6.8 tons of excess carbon dioxide everyday emissions by tiles into the air. It has low maintenance cost. It has waterproofing and damproofing. Harvesting human power to produce energy is best practice in order to fulfill the energy demand. Photovoltaic glazing. Building integrated photovoltaic glazing can help the building to generate their own electricity through solar powers. Developers use photovoltaic glasses as a building material, forming windows and roofs. The various applications of photovoltaic glazings are roofs, shading system, semi-transparent facades, external building walls, skylights, etc. This can greatly help in saving the energy cost as well as healthy environment in a longer term. Thank you.
A warm greetings to all. Now we are going to discuss about a topic called mensuration and how it is used in surveying and what is surveying. Okay. What is mensuration? Mensuration is a process of defining geometric shapes. Geometric shapes means square, rectangle, circle, cuboid, sphere, parabola, ellipse. It is also a use of measurement, where we use measurements to define a shape or quantity of a material in the Earth's surface in its physical scale. In day-to-day life, where we use mensuration? Mensuration is used in costumes, art and piece, roads for traveling from one position to another, or even drinking cocktails. For drinking cough syrups, we are measuring it in a measuring cap for 5 mm or 10 mm. This measuring is also a part of mensuration. What we have learned in mensuration? First, length. In surveying, this distance. And the second thing is two dimensions, a length and a breadth, where we have recorded area and pavement. And the third thing is with third dimension, with length, width and depth, where we have studied about volumes. And then fourth is length and angle. Using length and angle, we can identify slope of a position. What is a slope? Slope is a difference in elevation between two points with respect to the distance between those two points. Okay. What is surveying? As you have known, surveying is an art and science. Surveying is creating a map. Surveying is creating a structure in a paper to the Earth's surface. What is surveying? Surveying is the science of positioning physical elements in the Earth's surface, either creating an element or positioning element which is already present in the Earth surface. Surveying is not only in the Earth surface, surveying is also done in the cosmos by positioning the cosmetic substances, which is also a part of surveying. Surveying is definitely an art, as we are drawing the physical substances on the Earth into a paper, and it is also a creation where we have laid stones for creating a structure which is drawn in a paper to the ground surface. How surveying is important in India? Surveying is as small as convenient as creating a house in your plot to most complicated things in the world as splitting a country and sharing a ground. Surveying helps in various skills like establishing the boundaries of road, designating new roads or extending new roads, rivers, identifying height of a mountain, depth of a water body, and their flows. It is also used in distributing and redistributing the district, states, even countries. Survey is also used in positioning heavenly bodies like moon, planets, stars with respect to the Earth's surface. These are some examples of surveying where a person is measuring distance between two points in this picture and where the moon is and the position of recording the depth of water body in the pond. How surveying is done? Surveying is done with the principle of geometry. Okay, the first principle is work from part to part. Let's see this first figure. Do you give me a suggestion? How will you draw these three triangles? You start from the triangle larger triangle to the smaller triangle or from smaller triangle to the larger triangle. Yes, we will start from the larger triangle to the smaller triangle. Why we are doing this? We are doing this for two reasons. First one is to accurately place the position of triangles, we need to draw the larger triangle first. And the next thing is to avoid errors, we should draw the larger triangle so that drawing the smaller triangles will be accurate as much as possible. Yes, this is the principle of solo. And the next principle is locating the point on two independent points or a position. Let us see the second model. For drawing a triangle ABC, for establishing a point C in a triangle ABC, you need two distances from A and B. These two distances from two independent points A and B will give you the accurate position of C so that you can form a triangle A, B, and C. Likewise, to develop a point, you need two independent points or a position. For positions, we can take two different distances like D1 and D2, or an angle and a distance, or an angle and a distance on the same line, or angle and distance on different points, or from two angles. Using these techniques, you can identify the third point from two different points. These are the two principles within statistical surveying, which you have learned in geometry also. What are the tools used in surveying? How does surveying is done? Surveying is done using these tools in previous years, and now you have advanced techniques. Let's start with the basics. We use tapes and chains for measuring distances. We use compass, crosstabs for measuring angles. We use kilometers, learning caps for measuring the slope. And we use cosmologies. Cosmologies is an ancient device which is used by the sea travelers to position the pyramid bodies, which is the landmark for them to travel in the seas. Cosmologies are used in various civilizations, various time periods with various This one such example. And the telescopic instruments. Do you know why we use telescope? Yes. We use telescope to view the object which is located at long distances with more accuracy. Yes. For collecting surveying on a large scale, we use telescope to accurately position the point and accurately record a point on a longer distance. Telescopic instruments is a view of light which can measure distances and angles. And then we use dumpy levels and ultravirals which can look at heights and elevations of an object or a point which is located at longer distances. Surveying is proven difficult during those days, that they have to plot the diagram on the field itself, which is difficult when they are undergoing in deep like these circumstances. The most difficulties in surveying are three. First, to reach to the place where the survey has to be, as you see in this photo. And the next thing is to go to the point is first difficulty, and to record the point from a larger distance is the second difficulty, and the third difficulty is time. And another difficulty in surveying is, after recording the points in the field, they have to extensively draw the surface details in a paper, which is also proven as most difficult in this period of 1950s and 60s. Now, they have implemented many modern techniques in minimizing the difficulties in recording and displaying the details recorded during surveying. One such kind is laser. Do you know what laser is? Yes. light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Laser is one of the most extensively used measuring technique for most accurate methods. For measuring using laser, we use the principle called principle of time of flight. What this principle says, it is now when the light is transmitted from the transmitter, it goes on traveling until it is pointed to the reflector or a place where it is to be positioned, and the light will be reflected from the reflector and it will be transmitted directly to the receiver, which is at the same position of transmitter. This time of travel and the velocity of laser will give you the distance between the two points. This same principle is used in surveying in equipment like rotor station, geodimeter, televimeters. These are laser equipped devices which is used to measure distances between two points with most accuracy and with very minimal of time. For recording a point, it takes less than a second. If you are given with a tape to measure 100 meter distance, what will be the time to travel to the 100 meters? It takes around 2 to 5 minutes. And you need a tape of 100 meters for the 20 meters. You need 5 minutes for 20 meters. It will take around half an hour. Now, using laser, it will be taking a second. Now, we can assume how much faster and accurate the lasers are. And the last important technique for human is multi-station, where the laser pointer is used to measure the points and it is recorded into the device and it is also converted into a diagram using computer-aided software, so that the drawing of points will be not much as difficult in the previous exercises. Let us see a video how a rotor station is recording in a field. First, positioning of the boundaries of the plot is done as simple by placing your points on the corners of the cell. Then the landmass is border. From the landmass border, we can develop the building as in the plan, just by placing the prism on every corner. Now the landmass is marked. From that position, we can position the type of buildings, and the buildings are constructed on internal buildings. This is an example of total station by building. This video sponsored or video shared on YouTube by Leica Total Station Instruments. It is a famous company in providing total stations. Thank you. Now, let us conclude the session by learning that insulation is the most important technology or science for surveying and civil engineering. Every part of engineering has a basic in their sciences, and by upgrading and learning the basics of science, you can excel in any part of engineering. I hope this video has given you a good insight on engineering. Total stations, surveillance, and stations, and hope you will enjoy the further sessions. Thank you.
A warm greeting to all. Now we are going to discuss about application of basic concepts in civil engineering. Let us start our session with seismogram. Seismogram is a graph output by a seismograph. It is a record of ground motion at a measuring station as a function of time. Seismograms typically record motion in three directions. It is used to find the magnitude of earthquake in terms of Richter scale. Let us see the working principle of seismograph. Generally, earthquake causes due to movement of ground motion. Due to that, ground motion produces oscillation in simple pendulum, and that concept is adopted to plot the amplitude in seismograph. For horizontal seismograph, the oscillation of simple pendulum is used to record the ground motion. In similar way, for vertical amplitude are determined by using oscillation of spring. Now we compare earthquake versus TNT explosion. If the magnitude is 2 produces by 1 ton of TNT explosion. In similar way, if the magnitude is 8 means we are all guessed at 4 ton, but the answer will be wrong. Let us see the answer. Richter scale. Richter scale is also called Richter magnitude scale or local magnitude scale, which measures strength of earthquake, which was developed by Charles F. Richter, and he adopted logarithmic scale for some specific reason. What will be the reason? Which is the most important interesting factor? Let us see that interesting factor. Before that, we have to keep the some points. Remember, each magnitude increases, then tenfold times of amplitude increases, and 32 times of amount of energy released. Let us refresh about logarithm. It is the inverse function to exponent form. In this logarithmic table, if 2 power 4 equal to 16, then log base 2 16 equal to 4, which give a exponent form value. Similarly, for log 100 means which is equal to 10. Generally, log means log 10. Let us compare of various station amplitudes. After an earthquake, Richter wants to compare the amplitude of all station, but it is difficult to plot in single graphs. So he used logarithmic technique to plot in single graph, because if the amplitude value is 1000 means, then it will be convert for logarithmic form 3, then it will be used to plot in single graph. If we are using amplitude values mean, one of the value is 10 and another value is 1000 and another value is lakh, like that values. So we will not use normal values to plot the graph, but in logarithmic, 10 will be given as 1 and 100 will be given as 2 and 1000 will be given as 3 in logarithmic scale, and we will plot and compare within a single graph. It will be very easier. Okay, let us see the answer for magnitude 8. If the magnitude is 8, then the value is 32 power 6, because each value of magnitude increases, which produce 32 time of amount of energy release of earthquake is also increases. For that purpose, we all already know that magnitude is 2 means 1 ton amount of TNT explosion blast. For magnitude 8, 32 power 8 minus 2 equal to 6, 32 power 6, which gives 1 billion ton. Earthquake zone. Seismic zone in India. Seismic zone in India and Indian subcontinent is divided into 4 seismic zones, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Based on scientific inputs relating to seismicity, earthquakes occurred in the past and tectonic setup of the region. For zone 2, severity is less, but in zone 5, severity is high. For zone 2, the seismic measure must be less preference to be given. For zone 5, we give more preference for construction and design based on the seismic design. And one of the best among the seismic measuring technique is base isolation technique. Base isolation is a state of the art method in which The structure is separated from base by introducing suspension system between the base and the main structure. Let us see the base isolation technique. In this picture, one of the building is fixed base structure and another one is isolated structure. When a ground motion produces, then the entire structure will drift. But in isolated structure, only the suspension will drift and less amount of shock will be produced in this base isolated structure. So the damage will also less. The next technique is kinetic footfall technique. It is not a seismic technique. It is used in some of the well-developed countries. Kinetic footfall. Kinetic footfall is a new source of electricity which captures the energy from human footfall to generate electricity. Let us see the mechanism of kinetic footfall works. It consists of three small device. Over that small device, a tile is placed. When a person walks over this, then this device will spin. Due to this spinning effect, will convert into energy, and that energy will produce electricity, which as in this picture shown, an emission of LED light. When a person walks over this, then it generates electricity. Installation and placement of kinetic footfall as shown. This kinetic footfall is adopted in various places like sports academy, dance academy, supermarket, theaters, and most crowded places, which will give or generate more electricity. Thank you.